goes through his skid. Like, it's got to be tough on guys. Do you have an idea of what guys are feeling like in the locker room right now?
We just know that we go harder in practice. We figured out some a flaw that we get to keep working on. They pressed us really well and they trapped us really well, so we're going to go back to the drawing board and try to figure this out together.
Despite the 14 turnovers in the first half, you guys are only down two. What are you thinking at halftime? Are you thinking you can come back and make a run there in the second?
Yeah, we played together the whole game. We played really well. We played pretty bad the first half. And we're like, well, we're down two with an okay game. We were playing okay. So we had a good feeling going into the second half, and just made a couple of mental mistakes.
Surprisingly, even during this skid, it seems like you guys are finding some glimmers of hope and can stay relatively positive. How are you able to do that right now?
We know we're a new team, we're a young team, so we know that there's going to be trials and tribulations. But we know that if we stay together, it doesn't matter what's going to happen because we're getting better. That's all that matters right now.
You're still seeing signs of progress from game to game with some of the younger guys?
Game to game, day by day, practice. They're getting better, they're figuring things out. And that's all you can ask of them. It's really hard going from high school basketball to college basketball to throwing the fire starting. So they're doing everything we ask them, and we're just trying to make them learn as much as possible, as quick as possible, so we can turn it over.
You have another good individual game numbers. Are you able to enjoy that at all while you guys are in the middle of this?
I mean, we got practice tomorrow. You don't have time to think about stuff like that because that stuff doesn't really matter. If you lose a game, you lose a game. So it's about the team and not so much me.
It seems like as well as you guys played defensively in the first half, they were able to find some open looks for three in the second. Was that breakdowns that you guys had, or did they start making adjustments? What went differently there in the second?
They're a very good team. They stay confident. They don't look over all the bad things that they did in the first half. So they really keep their head and just keep pushing, and that's what makes them a really good team.
What did you guys see early against them? Like, it looked like you guys, I think, three of the first five went to King, and then you broke the seal a little bit and you got on a little bit of a run. What were you seeing against them in the low post?
We kind of just played through what coach kind of told us what to do. What we do is go inside out, and that's how we always start the game and go through each game. So we just went with what was working, going inside and working that.
A lot of the guys obviously look up to you. Is this a time when you speak to the younger guys about trying to stay positive, trying to continue to grow, anything like that?
I stay in their head just like all of our seniors. That's something we do really well is we try to make sure we stay positive and stay in our younger team, our younger players' heads, because this does get frustrating sometimes, but they have to understand that there's positive coming out of this.
Anything else?
Thanks, Marcus.
Appreciate it.